It's our honour to have with us Andrew Waggott, the Energy Services Manager of Portsmouth City Council. It's very interesting if you could tell us something about the work that you are doing with renewables and energy in Portsmouth, because we know that you are in the forefront of what's happening at the moment at the UK.
That's very kind. Thanks, Leo. So in Portsmouth, we've got an attitude where we're trying to invest heavily in renewables mm-hmm. and low carbon technologies, and you know, so lots of around about we have about a £2 million a year pipeline of investments in solar PV, typically in terms of generation, but also CHP. We've invested quite heavily in low energy lighting mm-hmm. and insulation and all those sorts of measures you'd expect within the building envelope and building services to try and reduce energy efficiency, to try and create energy efficiency, reduce energy. We've been successful in reducing Portsmouth's buildings' carbon emissions by around mm-hmm. 30-40% over the last sort of 8 years or so. And we also have lots and lots of work going on into the domestic sector as well, specifically targeting fuel poor households. So we've got, again, investment pots of funding where we are trying to get people out of fuel poverty by visiting homes of vulnerable households, by offering free boiler swaps and first-time central heating for households that are currently on electric heating as well. So we've got kind of that whole gamut covered, I suppose, in Portsmouth, and trying to help with both the sort of commercial energy efficiency side of things, the production of renewable energy, but also trying to reduce fuel poverty in the city as well, which is still a big problem. Yeah.
So you have progress to support the most vulnerable and upgrade the building stock.
Absolutely, yes. Yeah. So we have a social housing stock, and within our social housing stock, we've done most of what you would describe as the easy measures already. So most of those are on gas or district heating. They're all cavity wall and loft insulated. When we come into the private sector, though, you find that there are a lot of properties that don't have even the basics done. And it's really there where we're trying to focus our efforts to get people off the most inefficient forms of heating mm-hmm. and to try and encourage them to take up insulation measures as well, but also just to give help and advice. And to do that, we visit around about 500 households a year and offer help and advice. And that's what Stephanie and Ricardo were reporting on yesterday with the LEAP project and some of the work that's come out of that as well.
So the challenge is in terms of investment that it's lacking in order to cover the private sector, or the private sector is reluctant to take on the funds that they are in.
So the biggest issue is still in that private sector. But what we've tried to do in Portsmouth is, it's not so much investment, but more going to seek grants that can help cross tenure. So mm-hmm. so we don't care who what the tenure or the ownership of the properties is. We really care about who the person inside of that property is. So if that's a household who are vulnerable to incurring high fuel costs, or they frankly don't understand their bills, or they're on high tariffs and those sorts of things, we will step in, give advice and support and technical interventions that are appropriate for each of those situations.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I hope that a lot of local authorities will take on your example.